All right, we are live with number three of the Newton Piano Summit online, and this is quite a different mix. I mean, we've seen a lot of quote-unquote jazz people, but we've always presented more things, global music and some other kinds of music. We expect to do a lot of different kinds of music, some classical, some boogie-woogie, some blues, some, you know, funk and whatever. So actually, I could think of no better person to kick this off than you, Debo Ray. Oh, and I'm so pleased. It's sad we didn't get to go do the concerts live as we originally planned, and we would be doing this right now at the United Parish of Auburndale, which is a wonderful location. We did all those concerts last year there. In any case, if you want to find out more about Debo Ray, she has her own website, but you can find it find everything you want to know about this concert series by going to newtonpianosummit.org. And don't be surprised, it's on the Wobbin Improvement Society's webpage, which, of course, is the originator of this whole series. And we're very happy that that's the case. And we're also very happy for everybody else who's pitched in to make this happen. People like the Village Bank, Honda Village, the Massachusetts Cultural Council, and the Newton Cultural Council. We've had the grants. Anyways, all that information is also at this place. So I'm not going to spend any more time talking about it. Let's just let Debo Ray make some music for us. So go for it.
Awesome. Thank you, Chris. And thank you so much for having me here. It's always a pleasure to play, and especially with everything that's going on right now. I just love that there is an opportunity to still play some live music. So I'm going to play a few songs, and they're mostly, I would like to say, derivative of jazz, like a lot of R&B influences in my music. And so wanted to do a mix of some of my music as well as some covers, and hopefully a special guest will come in a little bit later. So we'll start off with a song called Love Is You by the wonderful singer and pianist Chrisette Michelle. And I am very much a singer before I am a pianist. So I am accompanying myself. Be kind with me as I figure that out. But wanted to give the best that I can. Here is Love Is You.
What's your definition of it? How's it make you feel? Tell me what you'd say that truly makes it real. Kings and queens, philosophers have tried so hard to find. Tell me what it means to you, dear. Never mind. Love is kind when the world is cold. Love stays strong when the fight gets old. Love's a shoulder to lean on, and love is you. Love is like a kiss when the sun goes down. It holds me close when no one's around. Love is what I want to hold on to. Love is you. 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 Is it possible there is a kiss that's so divine? Or am I just a fool? Is it all in my mind? Is it something chemical? Scientists might say, love must be a drug to make me feel this way. 'Cause love is my permission to be who I am. No inhibitions, 'cause you understand. Freedom to breathe, oh baby, love is you. Love is like the water where the well runs dry. Quench my thirst and keep me alive. Love is what I wanna hold on to. Love is you. Love is you. love is you.
Oh, that was beautiful. Nice.
Thank
you. Yeah.
Thank you so much. How's it sounding, by the way?
Well, you know, it sounds great to me. I hope people aren't, you know, it's the problem with the internet is it stutters and does stuff. But so when I heard the playback of some of the tests we did, there wasn't any of the stuttering on there. So, you know, hopefully people, and you can let us know this in the comments, please. You know,
yeah, please.
If you're having problems, you know, hearing it, is the stuff stuttering? So not only does that help us make decisions, but it also helps the people who are on top of this technology make it better. So, because they want it there. So let's see. I just want to... Oops, just keep going here. There we are. Anyway, so hey, I'm going to, so hopefully we can do things to make it better. So,
yeah, I see what you're doing there.
So I'm going to let her, we're just going to, you know, you go ahead.
Oh, sweet. Thank you, Chris. Chris was mentioning about making things better, and this next song is called Make It Better. This is an original that I wrote a few years back in the midst of a relationship that I wanted to make better, because, you know, when you fall in that little rut and you just want to let things work themselves out, and sometimes they can, and you have to be patient and that whole nine. So here's a song that doesn't only go out to all the lovers out there, but let's send that energy forward to the people who are taking care of tech. Here's Make It Better.
Love came easy to us.
Make it better.
Nice. Oh, that's so nice.
Thank you.
Yeah. I really, I love your chords. I love the, you know, the colors that you bring in there. It's really, not typical. You know, it's just enough like clever little left turns in there to keep you interested, and it's like, wow, oh, I like that. So good for you.
Working with chromatic descending bass lines.
oh, she's educated. Look out! Did you go to music school or?
Yes, I did. I went to Berkeley.
Oh
actually.
Yes.
Yeah.
Seems like everybody went to Berkeley.
Like we say, we're all just like in the same circles and networks. And,
I mean, especially in this area, the New England area, it's really, you know, between NEC and Berkeley and maybe a couple other schools, they got it covered. So, and especially in, you know, I would say my generation on, schools were really, I mean, there wasn't clubs. I mean, when I say my generation, because I saw in where there were a lot of clubs in cities, and I watched them just close down like the plague had hit, and just so that now in cities, if you have a club or a quote maybe jazz club, but club that presents music 7 days a week is pretty rare. And you know, back in the '60s, I saw a listing of clubs in Detroit. It looked like a phone book. I mean, there were just thousands of clubs. So you know, the evolution has changed very much, and part of that is how this music, how any music has been passed on to learn. Because there was a lot of bandstand learning back in those days, and you know, really the only way to do it now is to many of the clubs and I mean many of the schools. Anyways, I'll get out of your way and take it away.
Honestly, yeah, that kind of goes into this next song. This was a song that I would not ever have listened to if not for my experience at Berkeley. This is a song called Riverman by Nick Drake. And, you know, these songs tend to be really obscure. This particular one came out in the 70s by a singer-songwriter akin to, like, Joni Mitchell and people like that. And it was in an experience with a colleague that they showed me this song. They were like, yeah, this string arrangement and all this stuff. I was like, oh, my God, what is this? Why don't I know about this? So that in conjunction with just what we're doing right now, being online, this is the new club. You know, all of you who are tuning in right now live, like, getting this experience and feedback in real time and then sending the music out into the universe, into the interwebs, that's the new club. So I really appreciate being here and being able to be a part of that new paradigm. So here is Riverman. And for this one, I'm going to be also utilizing my TC Helicon Voice Live Touch, so you're going to hear some effects.
Ah! Ooh.
Riverman.
Said she had a word to say about things today and fallen leaves. Said she hadn't heard the news, hadn't had the time to choose a way to lose. But she believed. Gonna see the river man, gonna tell him all I can about the band on lilac time. And if he tells me all he knows about the way his river flows and all night shows in summertime. Oh. Sure. For when for more. Gonna see the river man. Gonna tell him all I can about the band. I'm feeling free.
Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, I see my wife actually Facebooked. She says, give me chills. Give me chills, too. That was something.
Thank you.
Would I be wrong to say this is similar to some of the things you do with the women of the world?
Yeah, especially that first part, the more improvisatory part on the top. That's a lot of what I'll do with women of the world. Just catering to different sounds from different cultures.
Oh, yeah. I love that about that group. I mean, you've done some wonderful work and some great videos. People need to check your video stream. What's your URL? Deboray.com or something?
Yep, Deboraymusic.com.
Ah, perfect. So you need to check it out because you're involved in so many things and different kinds of projects. I love that. You're not pigeonholed into one thing because your creativity is... You know, you're supposed to be open to all kinds of things, but you have beautiful focus. And, when we first talked about you appearing, I think you were on the road with Terry Lynn Carrington out on the West Coast somewhere. And we talked about, doing this series. We connected at various times before that, but this was a good chance to suddenly bring you to the Newton Piano Summit. So here we are now. Here it is.
Here we
so,
are now.
in the Corona zone. So, anyways, take it away.
Awesome. This is a song that I absolutely adore by one of my favorite, I guess you can call them film composers, named Yoko Kanno from Japan. She is a prolific, super prolific composer, and she has a tendency, kind of like me, to write in a bunch of different styles. So she was writing for a show called Cowboy Bebop, which has a lot of blues and R&B and jazz elements to it, to the score. And this particular song stood out to me just for its moodiness. So we're going to stay moody for this next one. This one's called Butterfly. Flight of a stringless kite.
Nice. Oh, that's nice. Yeah. Uh-oh. Looks like Wes just... maybe we can get Wes to join us for a little bit, because he's been pretty integral in the last couple of years with the summit, and he's actually recommended people to be part of it. And I've been working with him. Yeah, including you, you know.
Thanks, Wes, for that.
There's one of the geniuses. Anyways, that was really something. Let's just keep going.
I'm actually super surprised that Wes decided to comment right now, because this next song is going to feature him.
Perfect.
It's like the timing, right?
Yeah. It's like his ears were burning.
All right. So seeing as this is live, I wanted to experiment with doing something live and responding to another musician because I'm really, really missing playing with people. And so knowing that live stream sessions with two people in different places is a little bit hard to do with all the lag issues. So I asked Wes to kind of give me something to work with, and he sent me one of his own songs called Sasquatch. So hopefully this works where you'll be able to see him there. It's a little bit out of focus, but you get the idea. But you'll be able to hear him, which is much more important.
Okay, let's make sure this works.
Oh, there's Wes!
Thank you.
Wow. That's really special. That's like, that's some new kind of stuff there. I don't, you know, it'd be hard pressed to say what kind of music that is, because it's dripping with all kinds of influences. Beautiful, beautiful. Hey, let me see. Uh-oh, surprise, guys.
Ah, hey.
There's Nando and Ebinho. Can't unmute your guests because they chose to mute themselves. Okay.
Oh,
okay. You guys have muted yourselves.
And
so
they got the masks on, too.
Oh, yeah, they got the masks. You got two guys in a room. Hey, you know, so we're just kind of being a little bit loosey-goosey about this, and I know you had another special song teed up.
What?
So if gentlemen, Ebinho and Nando, if you don't mind, we'll go over on your segment too. But can we do one more song with Debo, and then you guys will be ready?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, okay. So that's
thank
a
you.
Big solid approval. I love
it. Thank you for being so lenient with me.
You know, and we'll talk a little bit at the end. I don't want to take too much time here with everybody, you know, especially, you know, just time is so critical right now. So I'm just going to shut up and let Debo do the song. So
awesome. Well, this is my final song, of course. And thank you, Nando, again for being so awesome about that. This is the song from my band Fat Luca that was supposed to be the ones that performed at this in person for the Newton Piano Summit. Featuring a lot of awesome people from around Boston. And this is like strict R&B, kind of like neo-soul vibes. This is a song called The Game. And it's become my mantra throughout this time of just remembering that everything is going to change. The good changes to the bad. The bad inevitably changes to the good. Here's The Game. What's up? Yeah. The game. Yeah. Here we go. The day is done. Another evening has begun. A chance to stretch and unwind. Take off your shoes, let your hair hang loose, every worry and care left behind. Release all of the tension and prepare for deep reflection. It's all good in your neighborhood. Let the spirits dance around you, you know what you gotta do, 'cause it's all good. It's all good. Check it. Everything will change. That's how you play the game. Nothing stays the same. That's how you play the game. Let's say you're feeling real down, down, down. Gotta frown, everything feels like it's wrong. Can't even sing a song, but this won't last for long. No, no, you are dealing with impermanence. Life don't make sense. Take a deep breath, a deep breath. Release all of the tension and prepare for deep reflection. It's all good in a body. Around you, you know what you gotta do. You can make it all. That's the game.
Woo-wee. Wow, that was, you know, I just feel the thing, you know. Oh, yeah.
You know? The vibe. It's all about the vibe.
Oh, man. That's so nice. That's really, nice. I just want to, without taking too much time, but I want to reiterate how this context that we're in, this kind of one-to-one, you know, I'm in you're in your house, and Nando and Ebinho are in your house. It's so intimate in a way that's really kind of different. You know, I don't know, you know, you don't get, it's not like we're playing a video you made. It's not like, you know, it's its own little vibe to it. I don't know if the public feels the same way, but I really sense there's a different kind of thing. When Yoko did her, the first one, we just said, you know, this is kind of, it's funny. It's, you know, we're in her living room. And you know, having a little wine or whatever, but you know, we're just all stuck in our own little houses in our environment, and yet this is a really amazing way of reaching across that divide, you know. So
feeling each other, it's all about connection.
Yeah. How tell me a little bit how you've been after the bomb went off. You know, what was, you know?
Oh yeah, I was mid tour. Actually, so I had to leave my tour and come back home to Boston. And at first, I didn't quite understand what was happening, as I'm sure everyone felt the same, like, what is going on, actually. But I had already been prepped in a way for this, because being a musician, being always traveling, a part of what I do is I have to carry all of my stuff with me and be able to perform at the drop of a hat. So this time has been less about making sure that I get more content out there and more about being introspective now that the entire world's on pause. Really, like, what is serving me and what isn't, and letting go of what isn't. That's been the task lately.
Yeah. You guys feel that you have a similar experience? I know, I think, Nando, you do a lot of teaching, right?
I do. That, for me, kept being the same, but the music creativity, first of all, I stopped commuting, so I had more time to practice and write and be more creative. So that was, you know, that's something that helped. But the interaction is lost. Now in the case of Ebinho, we go way back, so we started with all the percussions and wearing a mask and all that. We started getting together and rehearsing and creating music together. But that interaction of you sending recording to somebody, that person records on top of it, then sends it back, and then you create something together, is something that's here to stay. You know, it's good that we got used to it and that we started working on it and learn. You know, sometimes I feel like my generation got through a couple of curves. You know, like we started with the idea of recording an album and, you know, taking it to the radio stations and the record labels, and that turned into, you know, like something else completely different, and now it's turning into something different yet again. So, and I think this is going to be the new normal is instability, you know, it's not knowing what comes to us, and we have to adapt, you know. And if it's videos, if it's learning how to edit video, that should be, and if it's learning how to deal with Pro Tools, that should be, and, you know, our creativity is what is a common ground, you know.
Yeah.
That's what's going to stay.
Yeah. The you know, being adaptable as you know, musicians are. You have to be able to do that to survive. And but it's interesting. I mean, we talked about that before with you know Debo. You're really, you know, your video skills are really impressive. And that's part of the tool book. As Nando was just saying, you know, we have to do different things to be an artist. And I don't think even post COVID, when you know clubs like this one will fill back up with people and we'll be back sort of as we were before, I don't think this part of it that we've discovered more so is ever going to go away, because this reaches
at least until we get a vaccine, you know. Then but then it will be something else, man. I mean, that's the thing. It's like you can't just think, okay, when that happens, everything's going to go back to the way it used to be.
Yeah.
I mean, it's going to change. And luckily for us, this is not a really devastating virus. If it was something that would kill instantly, then, you know, we'll have to get adjusted to it for a while. You know, it's...
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to get depressive.
The point I was trying to make is I don't think this kind of intimate thing that we've discovered here with this online streamcasting from people's houses, I think that's a new facet, and I don't think that people are going to relinquish that even with the vaccines or whatever. It's like we're going to expect all of you to come back and be in touch with us this way, because this is really special kind of linkage that you can't do in a club and you can't do through a video. This is just really special.
Absolutely.
So
this is here to stay, that's for sure.
This is here to stay.
And it's gonna be a mix of things. You know, we're still gonna have the clubs eventually, and we're still gonna have the real live performances, because there's no substitution for that. But this is here to stay for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, this show is supposed to be about music, so I guess we'll talk less and do music. Debo, we'll see you a little bit later on.
Yeah, see you.
And
later.
Thank you so much. And, you know, again, I say to everyone, I'm not going to go through all your bios and stuff. They're lengthy. They're extensive. You have amazing experience. I will say that I was reading about your recording that you've done. It's Heroes. What's it called? Heroes. The one that you and Ebinho, Nando, you just released.
Ingenieros.
Engineers. And
Engineers.
And it. And it's about you said it's based on the poetry of you know, your gem poet from Brazil, one of a poet laureate or somebody,
yes,
but
exactly,
recognized in your country as being, you know, one of the paramount intellectual contributors in the field
of
poetry.
All the music we play today, except for one tune, all the tunes we play today are using poems. The first one is by João Cabral de Melo Neto, and the other ones are by Manoel de Barros, two of the greatest poems from Brazilian music.
Well, that sounds great.
Shall we?
Yeah, let's do it.
Desordem na alma que se atropela sob esta carne que transparece. Desordem na alma que te foge. Vaga fumaça que se dispersa. Informe nuvem que te cresce e cuja face nem reconheces. Tua alma foge como cabelos, cunhas, humores, palavras ditas que não se sabe onde se perde. Impregno a terra com sua morte. Tua alma escapa alma, este corpo, solto no tempo que nada impede. Procura a ordem que fez na pedra. Nada se gasta, mas permanece. Essa presença que reconhece. Não se devora tudo em que cresce, nem mesmo cresce, pois permanece fora do tempo que não a mede. Pesado sólido que ao fluido vence, que sempre ao fundo das coisas desce. Procura a ordem desse silêncio que move ou fala, silêncio puro de pura espécie, voz de silêncio. Mas o que ausência que as vozes ferem, de pura espécie, voz de silêncio. Mas do que ausência que as vozes ferem.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Thank you. How's it sound there?
It sounds good here. People seem to like it. I'm getting a lot of comments. So people are like, Anna thinks that you guys are great, you know?
She's wonderful. We love Anna too. Hey, Anna.
And Debo's listening to it because she's a sound engineer too. So she thinks it sounds great. So people are checking in like it's an onslaught. So anyways, let's just keep going, guys.
Good. We have a guest for the next song. We have Ian the Bussis Cardoso singing with us.
Oh.
Also with a mask, we decided to keep him on, you know, just as a statement of safety here, but you know. We'll have it. Okay, so Ian is going to sing for us a song called Novo Mundo, New World, with lyrics by my good friend from Brazil, Antonio Loureiro.
Oh, that's great.
De apanhar.
Bravo.
Yeah.
Oh, that was so nice. You guys just keep going, okay?
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm going to adjust my sound here for the next song. A little bit here. And we'll do Desde el Comienzo del Mundo, Since the Beginning of Times. Beautiful poem by Manoel de Barros. song that I wrote together with Ebinho.
Desde o começo do mundo, água e chão se amam. E se entram amorosamente e se fecundam. Nascem peixes para habitar os rios e nascem pássaros para habitar as árvores, as águas ainda ajudam na formação dos caracóis e das suas lesmas. As águas são a epifania da criação. Agora eu penso nas águas do Pantanal. Declives para escorrer, porque as águas deste lugar ainda são espraiadas para a alegria das garças. Estes pequenos corichos ainda precisam de barrancos para se comportarem em seus leitos. Penso com humildade que fui convidado. Eu fui convidado para o banquete dessas águas, porque sou de bugre, porque sou de brejo. Acho agora que estas águas que bem conhecem a inocência de seus pássaros e de suas árvores, que elas pertencem também de nossas origens. Louvo tanto esta fonte de todos os seres e de todas as plantas, vês que todos somos devedores destas águas. Louvo ainda as vozes dos habitantes deste lugar, que trazem pra nós, na umidez de suas palavras, a boa inocência de nossas origens.
Wow. That's so beautiful. Thank you. Very special.
Let's do Desli Miches da Palavra featuring Ian again.
Come on.
Ian.
So beautiful. Ah.
Thank you. Thank you, Chris.
Is there a story behind that one?
Say that again?
Is there a little story behind that tune?
That poet, Manoel de Barros, he likes to play games with new words he creates. He talks a lot about how grammar shouldn't define the objects. He looks a lot at the minuscule things in life. Like, you know, he talks about one of his biggest statements is my backyard is bigger than the whole world, because he can find there things that he can use for everything to describe, to get all his poetry based on those little tiny things. In this case, he talks about the unlimits of the words, and it's a very complex poetry. He makes simple things complex and complex things simple. You know, it's hard to describe his poetry for non-Brazilian speaking, non-Portuguese speaking people, but it's amazing poetry. I think there's like four or five of his poems traduced to English. But it's not an easy translation, because it's a lot of made up words, you know.
Oh, that's great. He's a jazz musician. I beg that I don't know. Wasn't familiar until actually I saw this, you know, what you were doing, and I started looking it up and trying to follow it. And it's definitely pretty, very rich. So, hey, keep going.
This is our also by Manoel de Barros. When the world leaves my eyes, cuando el mundo abandonara mi olho. This is all part of our next project that we have a single coming out pretty soon. And we finished recording some of the tunes, and we plan on finishing it as soon as it's safe to go back to the studio. It's from our next CD, When the World Abandons My Eye.
Fazer se de repente amanhã de meu olho não for mais. fazer se de repente amanhã voltar aqui? Hei de fazer que hei de fazer dormir talvez chorar. Talvez chorar, dormir talvez chorar, dormir talvez.
Well, that's beautiful. Very, very nice.
Thank you.
Let's see. Well, we got a lot of comments here. But I wanted to put... here we go. So everybody knows who's who. So here's a question that came up. We've been doing these at 1 o'clock because they were left over from... That was the start time at the live concerts that we've been doing for the last... four years, and but this is a new world, new time, and you always want to re-examine what you're doing, and it was suggested that we should do this at 4 instead of 1 p.m. on Saturday. So I'll let the viewers give us the answer. You know, if you want to type in your answer, what if you think would be better at 4 instead of 1, please let us know. The other thing I wanted to say before we get going too far is that a wonderful musician we're all familiar with, anybody in New England, in fact, is familiar with Alexei Tsiganov, is an incredible pianist who plays in Latin, in jazz, you know, any style. I love this guy to death because he's such a chameleon, and he's got everything you want in a musician, and is an example of the great musicians that have come through the Piano Summit. There are no slackers, and you gentlemen are proving that time and time again. So, actually, I'll just get out of the way, and you keep going.
We have time for a couple more.
Yeah. I'm not going anywhere.
Okay. One or two.
So we were planning on. Let's. Vamos fechar com esse aqui. Salmo ou apanhador.
Você que manda.
Want to do one more? Or?
Okay, let's do one more. We do.
Okay.
This is a Salmo psalm.
Okay, and that way we can have a little bit of talk at the end. Not too much. We're not about talking.
All right. So this is Salmo, a poem by Manoel de Barros again, music by us.
Para baixo que eu nasci tendo é um olhar para o ser menor, pro insignificante que eu me criei tendo. O ser que na sociedade é chutado como uma barata, cresce de importância pro meu olho. Ainda não entendi por que herdei esse olhar para baixo. Sempre imagino o que venha de ancestralidades machucadas. Coisinhas do chão antes que das coisas celestiais. Pessoas pertencidas de abandono me comovem tanto quanto a soberbas, coisas ínfimas. Pessoas pertencidas de abandono me comovem tanto quanto as soberbas, coisas ínfimas. Pessoas pertencidas de abandono me comovem tanto quanto as soberbas, coisas ínfimas.
Wow. I don't know if the internet's breaking up a little bit. Was it looking pixelated to you at all?
It's beautiful.
Anyways. Oh boy, that was so nice. This is such food for the soul. You know, medicine. Medicine, that's what it's medicine for the soul.
Yeah, and this nice, kind, man. Thank you.
Well, that was really beautiful. I encourage people to pick up your recording. That's a, you know, beautiful work. And again, you can find everything about everybody. You can find the links to their websites and everything at the newtonpianosummit.org. That will live on in perpetuity. You're part of the family, so that's always going to be. And you know, that also means that you'll be coming back, so... we love you more than you love us. actually, can you tell us again the name of your vocalist, your surprise guest back there, Nando?
Oh,
Ian.
Yeah. He's my son, man.
Oh, yeah, because, you know, we see, like, eyes and some hair, and, you know, it's like, you know, who the heck's under there? So it's all in the family. That's wonderful. I know somebody had commented to that effect, so yeah. That's great.
This band is a family band because my drummer is my son, too. The drummer.
But he lives in New York. And
he's in New York, but, you know, we have father and son there in the band.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. That's, you know, that's, well, we got a lot of response this time. We're just building and building. You know, we've been slowly, steadily. I mean, this time we have more people live. Like I said, the first one we did with Yoko and Maxim, within 24 hours, 1,000 people had seen it. So we must be doing something right, providing that medicine. And I really, today's show was really special because what a mix of just wonderful influences and new sounds and yet familiar. Yeah. I love the music you're all creating. They're going to send me home practicing.
As I told you last week, I always been a fan of Debo, you know, so it's great to share stage with her.
Yeah. You is incredible. Amazing. Yeah.
Thank you, guys. And you guys were just wonderful. Just warmed my heart listening to you guys.
Very inspiring. Very inspiring music. I'm so glad you guys were part of this today and that we decided to roll with the punches, right? The bomb went off. It's like nothing's stopping this music. No siree, Bob. So we're just glad to keep... You can't keep this talent down. I hope you all use this time to write some more music and come up with new stuff. And we'll have you back soon because we're just going to keep going. I've received some support from people. Question. People are asking, you know, how to support the Piano Summit, and that's pretty simple. Just go to our website. You will see you can make a tax-deductible donation. It's the Wobbin Improvement Society is the 501c3 organization, and they pass through all the money we get goes straight to these people here, these performers. There's, you know, no money being spent any other way. We didn't have to rent a hall. We didn't have to, you know, we didn't have to get a piano tuner. We didn't have to do any of that, you know. So absolutely 100% of the money. I'm not taking a dime to do this. I want to see this keep going. So my investment is coming from right here. That's where I get paid off. This is such beautiful music. I am so glad. I mean, this, you make more music than I've ever played with my saxophone. So It's very satisfying, and I just hope that we can keep building and building and keep going. So you out there who are watching, please, you know, $3, whatever you can, you know, $3, $30, $3,000, I don't care what it is, $30,000, you know, $3 million, no. You never know. You know, maybe Jeff Bezos is like, what will I do this afternoon? You know, say, hey, why don't we help these musicians out? You know, because they, all their gigs are gone. You know, everything is gone. They don't have, they don't have W-2s. Most of you, you know, who are, you know, maybe aren't teaching through an institution or something and depend 100% on the gigs. Well, that's all blown up. So it's very helpful to keep this going. That's what we're going to do. I can't promise this is happening, but I think that Bruce Foreman will be playing on this. I don't know if you know Bruce is, but Google him. He is an insanely great talent on the guitar from my old haunts in San Francisco. He was just, he's, you know, known as the great in his field. And he's been doing a project with a great pianist who's originally from Newton, no less, but Roger Kellaway. And he's the only person I know from here that has an Oscar and a Grammy and a, you know, he's done a lot of stuff. He lives out west. In fact, when we last talked to him, which is a long time ago, actually, but he had just come off an airplane with Tony Bennett. So, because Tony Bennett would fly his own band around, he's like the Rolling Stones, he has his own plane, and so he was on that. So the guy's a brilliant talent. So we look forward to having talent like that, and we're still waiting to hear from Chick Corea and Herbie Hancock if they will join us on this. But right now it's us and everybody who's watching, and you know, let's just keep the music rolling. So again, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, man.
All of that. And I let you have the parting thoughts to our public and whatever. So, Debo, if you have something you want to say or just, you know.
Yeah, I guess thank you so much for tuning in. For those of you who stuck through such a long live stream and you're supporting live music that way, every single person who's watching this, thank you so much. I hope that you're blessed and continue to support Newton Piano Summit. You're doing great things here, man. Chris, I'm so happy you're doing this.
Oh, you're so kind. You guys, Nando, Ebinho, and it's
thank you so much, man. I'm very happy. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Well, actually, I should point out, Ebinho, that you're actually, people are probably scratching their heads, at least in Newton, going, you know, hey, I've seen this guy somewhere before. And indeed, you've performed at a couple of our village days. And, you know, so you're not quite an unfamiliar face. And, you know, your talent has speaks pretty loudly. In fact, I just saw you at the Crash Fest.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Weren't you with Ebinho, the singer?
Sorry?
Right, was that Crash Fest? It was the
yeah, the last year we played together, me and Ebinho, 2 years ago, I think.
No, it was, for WAP, for Newton, yeah. But I'm just saying, I saw you down at the House of Blues. It was probably last, one of the last live concerts. It's funny, because, you know, it's, you know, House of Blues, right? And there were like a 1,000 people there, and 50 bands, and you know, oh my gosh, you know, who knows? It was early enough, I think, that where the virus hadn't really started up, so people, you know, that didn't walk away with viruses and things like that.
We need to say thank you for Ebinho, because this gig.
Thank Ebinho a lot. He really helped us with the technology and testing out. We were doing some trials.
See, you get
yeah.
to
try,
you know, just to make
right.
sure everything sounds good.
Like,
you know,
Devo, they know stuff. But yeah. That's great.
You gotta learn the new stuff, you know. You gotta keep learning new
it's
stuff.
True.
Chris, we really are really thankful to your entrepreneurship and putting this together. It makes us a lot of good to be able to put our music out there, you know, keep creating, keep doing it. You know, it really, it's healing for all of us. And for people that are listening, please remember that musicians don't have an income at this point. The musicians are legally, I'm thankful to my employers. I keep teaching. You know, but there's a lot of musicians out there that are struggling, trying to make ends meet. So any opportunity you have to donate either to Newton Piano Summit or also to like go to the pages. So, you know, we have a Patreon page together, Mechelin Cardoso. And, you know, you support people.
Think buy your music.
Instead of buying a cup of coffee, you just buy music and you make the world a better place.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And Debo, you have your... You're giving lessons online now.
I'm giving lessons online.
I started
a YouTube page. I have ways to keep connected to me and to make sure that we keep this language of music, especially improvised music, alive. It's a tradition that's oral, so we need to keep talking, keep performing, keep listening, keep that cycle up. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, anyways, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I want to thank everybody who's helped out and has done so much. Oh, we have a lot of comments here. Before we sign off, let's just visit. I think most of them are just saying that they really appreciate what we did. And we'll just keep going. We're going to keep going until the money runs out, folks. So just help us out and we'll keep going. I know that we are going into July. So, you know, right? We're going into July, and we're going to have, I mentioned a couple of, Rodney Whitaker said he wanted to come on, so we have to make sure that that's happening, but Rodney is an amazing bass player. He played with Winton for a number of years in the big band at Lincoln Center, and he played with Roy Hargrove for quite a long time. He's really an amazing musician, and kind of like you, Debo, a big thinker. Stuff like actually like all of you guys, you know, just all kinds of ideas and not limited by any kind of pigeonholing and stuff. And I think he directs the music program at Michigan State. So it'll be fun to have people. We have no boundaries now. You're in California, you're in Australia, wherever you want to come and play. We're welcome in our living room. So again, on behalf of Debo and Nando and Ebinho and his son and all of us at the Newton Piano Summit, which all of us, I say. Anyways, thank you very, very much. And we're going to say arrivederci, au revoir, sayonara,
thank you so
adios.
Much. Bye-bye. Adios.
All right.